topic is Bollywood is spoiling the people of India. And may I introduce the people? Start.
Are you?
Start.
Introduce.
You don't know him.
What are you doing? Oh, see you here.
Jay.
Aditya.
Suam.
Good morning, friends. I'm Rohan.
I'm Devanesha.
It's after.
Camera going on.
We are shy.
Friends, I'm Kusha.
Good afternoon, I'm Shalomi. Hello, friends. I'm Kruti.
And so, Rohan, what is your opinion? Yes, I firmly believe that Bollywood has a bad influence on the children, because as you can see, the songs which are presented before the children are not in a good sense. They are vulgar and they are spoiling the values which India has been giving to its children, like vulgar songs with like Munni Badnaam, Sheela Jawan. These songs are deteriorating the level of values which the children have been having from yours.
Okay.
See, these songs that he's talking about, they are famous around the country. And they are played at every occasion, be it a marriage, birthday party, done anything. Festival, anything. So, it's not like the Bollywood films are... Bollywood films are bad, because there are some very good Bollywood films which have been selected for the Oscars also. Films like
there have been zero Oscar nominations from India.
No, Lavan had gone to the Oscars.
No, it did not. It wasn't even a nominee. It was just Bollywood.
Slumdog Millionaire.
It wasn't an Indian film. It was just filmed in India. It was just filmed in India.
Children can learn different style of dancing, different music.
And
so
movies
it's
is like the best
also.
Yeah.
Movies
yeah.
Like the best made in our
cinema is the best entertainment.
Is the best entertainment.
You're the one. Yeah.
Okay, someone speak against it.
The cinema is the
you
best
can't
entertainment.
Really say
against
there are few movies which are
but
easy would, against.
There are few movies which are
all the senior actors are also...
Would you like if your child saw songs like Munni Badnaam and saw bad scenes, vulgar scenes in a movie, would you like it?
Vulgar scenes?
Yeah.
Can you not
yeah.
Now?
Kids are not allowed only for such movies.
At least, every movie has at least one reference, one suggestive remark. At least they are there. So, we cannot just ban kids from watching movies.
But if there are such movies also in which they speak abusive language.
Good
bad.
But A rating is given.
Yeah,
the censor board is very strict. The censor board is very
used. If they use a much of abusive language, then there is a A rating. But if they use only one, two words, then it's a UA. Is it fine that your kid comes in front of you and he says, Papa, Papa, what is the meaning of this word?
So that is
he's exposed to the word.
He's supposed to know that.
He's exposed to the word.
And you also get an education for that.
Education for that, you mean to say abusive language, you need education for that.
So someone comes and abuses
abusive
language.
Yeah.
Someone comes and abuses a kid and a kid just laughs and walks off.
What do you mean? Is it fine with you that your kid comes in front of you and asks you the word, what is the meaning of this?
Yeah,
he should know the meaning. He should know the meaning.
Children can
learn. He should be a blonde.
The difference is if you tell your children the meaning of the words, they will understand it and they won't do it again.
Yeah.
But if they hear it from some other source, then they won't know the meaning. They'll just go on blurting out whatever they hear.
So that's
so,
the
yeah.
That's why the movies are rated. I'm saying A rated.
Nowadays you get a movie on torrent within a month.
But children in the fourth or fifth standard don't know anything about torrent. They don't have.
They don't.
My friend.
Nowadays.
I have a friend who is in third standard and he speaks more bad.
It's one child.
So then internet is over.
His family background.
It's not so.
How do you know?
Guys, then you're blaming internet.
He's exposed to such bad mediums.
That's like blaming internet.
Not bad.
Internet.
His friends are great at doing all those things. Or maybe encouraging.
See, obscene language is always beeped out whenever it is shown on TV or something.
Yeah.
TV, but we are talking about.
When these people, when the small children see.
Yeah, so that's the thing. Friends are influenced by movies, and these friends have an influence on the child.
That's what we are trying to say.
Yeah.
That's what we are trying to say.
Yeah. It's a cycle. Movies, children, then it is passed on.
It's cycle.
What is a cycle? Bollywood
is so passed on. He's trying to say that
the way in which a child speaks to his friend.
Your friend sees a movie in which abusive language is used. He'll come and share it to you. And you'll just roam around saying that word.
Like seriously, who does that?
Yeah.
Dictionary or has to ask someone what is the meaning of that instead of using it without knowing the meaning. What if it has some other meaning?
Yeah, and the children and the child knows that it is abusive, then he must have that much brain that he will not use that language in front of anybody.
How will he know?
Yeah.
So, he asks, words,
how will he know?
He has to provide the abuse.
That's
what
I'm
saying.
The point is that we always have a tendency to look at the bad part of everything.
Right. Yeah.
Right.
Bollywood has such beautiful movies like Bhaag Milkha Bhaag.
Bhaag Milkha Bhaag also has
a beautiful
See, history is also a very boring subject, and movies are a medium of no, like your kids know about history.
So you mean to say that you want to take your kid to see Bhaag Milkha Bhaag where there are uncensored scenes also there in?
But Bhaag Milkha Bhaag is that type of a film.
It's
a very inspiring film.
No.
If you take it in the wrong sense, it is a very bad film
also. I'll give you an example. How can you give an example? If one rotten tomato is kept in a pack of the whole bunch of tomatoes, won't that spoil the others too? If one bad scene or a few bad scenes are there, then won't the child will pick up the bad things only.
Yeah. But we are not tomatoes.
Yeah.
We are not tomatoes.
It's only metaphor.
Yeah, so.
See, like, when you were a kid, I don't think you used to look at the bad scene.
I used to close my eyes and do like.
Yeah, even I used to just close my eyes.
Today's generation, I don't know. It might be really seen.
That's the point.
Yeah.
Children are influenced. Badly influenced.
If children wants to learn, it can learn from anywhere, not from only Bollywood. There are so many sources to learn.
Yeah.
So that's what
because
we are trying to say.
What is more famous other than cricket? Bollywood.
Are you with you, Baba?
No,
come on.
I'm not with him. You just gave a point which was with him.
Listen.
The Bollywood is not the only medium of.
You said that. Other things are also there from which the child can learn. So the first thing is the Bollywood. If he sees that thing, then he will do it.
No, children have education. They don't have Bollywood education.
See, if you see Hollywood
kindergarten, they're taught any family. They're not taught dialogue and all, kitne aadmi the and all.
In any family, two things are common. Cricket and Bollywood in India.
If you show your child movies like Titanic and so on, there are some scenes. You are saying that
so we would Bollywood is first. We'll think first.
You all guys are
we'll think first, na? Should we show this movie to our child? If there are some scenes,
there are Bollywood movies. There are.
We're talking about Bollywood movies.
Sure. This is just my point.
What is your
suggestion that Bollywood is
better than Hollywood. So now you change sides again. It's not all that.
Never.
So we didn't come to a conclusion.
You can never come to a conclusion.
You want to debate.
Yeah.
Continue.
There was only one negative point about Bollywood, that it has bad scenes and abusive language.
Yeah. Not every movie, not every movie.
Yeah, not every movie has bad.
Yeah, but like I said, one bad thing, the what's the normal tendency of children? They'll pick up the bad things first.
You can teach them.
Yeah. How will we know
that if they pick up the bad things
you
first,
have to show them. You have to show them.
You have not brought up that child well. Yeah. If they pick up the bad things,
you're blaming me.
No, exactly. If you are saying that.
Are you a parent?
No.
Are
you a parent?
I am a
See, if you say that, if a 5th standard child sees the bad scene, you should teach him. What will you teach? If there is a really bad scene, you will tell the response to it that this causes AIDS and that whole thing.
What?
You educate him.
Bad.
You are supposed to educate him at
the 5th standard. How will he come to know what's AIDS?
We have to
show him. How will he come to know that?
Acquired immunodeficiency syndrome.
I'm not telling that. If we are going to say,
you just said it that we should show him, we should teach him.
It doesn't.
See, there are very many ways of explaining a kid about many situations.
How will you explain it?
It's not necessary.
No, see, if a child watches a cricket match and if the South African team, if the South African team has a band here and they are wearing pink jersey, that is for promoting a type of cancer. Means not promoting it, but going against it.
How is cancer related to these?
So if the child asks why are they wearing pink jersey, what is this sign? What will you say at that time?
It's for a good cause.
That's for a good cause.
How is it related to Bollywood?
No, how is a bad guy?
Exactly. You are saying that. Come on,
you are being a bad kid then.
Bad parent.
That's what. How is a bad scene related to a good cause?
If they ask.
So then he will come to know that what is bad, what is good. He won't
You are going to give the definition.
Fifth standard kids are quite educated that they know it's a bad scene. They don't come and ask you, what is that, mumma? What are they doing?
They're not.
They are the very sad scenes, right?
I'm not saying I'm just saying that the kid knows. Nowadays the kids are that educated.
It is upon the kid if he wants to pick up the bad things or good things.
Yeah, it's upon the kid. How he looks
at it. And if he takes up a bad thing also, we are there to help him up in future.
How do you know that?
She's telling me our kid is educated.
How would you know that your kid has picked up such things?
Okay, just
come and tell you.
Just one question. Did you watch any you used to watch Bollywood when you were in 5th standard?
Yes.
You consider yourself as a spoiled child.
Exactly.
Yes.
So do you regret being a kid like this? Do you think that your parents were not devoted to that? So then you've been watching Bollywood all your childhood, why would it be bad for your kids when you are so mature enough now?
After a certain age, come on.
So now so kids don't become, they're not just born and you just don't put them in front of the TV, look, watch.
Yeah, that happens.
What?
Everybody does.
How will you understand what is going on?
If a kid sees a particular scene, he can distinguish whether it is good or bad. And normally most of the people will be inclined towards the bad things. That would be the normal tendency.
If the parents are bad, then the kids will be bad.
How can you blame the parents?
So why will the kid be bad? Why will the kid be bad originally? How will the kid be bad originally?
Bad influence. Yeah. Children watch Bollywood
movies
themselves.
There are not only the parents who influence the kid, there are many people who influence the kid.
Yeah.
Come on,
There's a whole society.
Kids, they are intelligent enough.
fifth standard is a mature age. They're 10 years old, 11 years old.
Achha, 10 years later, you can type it on Google, kids are smoking, fifth standard kid. I can show you right now, YouTube. Yeah.
Thank you for bringing that point. Smoking and alcohol. So, doesn't Bollywood promote that?